Here we're asked to solve an exponential equation. The right side, 5, is certainly not a perfect power of e. So I'm going to have to apply the 1-to-1 property for logarithmic functions and take the log of both sides. In fact, I'm going to take the natural log of both sides because the base there is e, and it'll be easier in the long run. So the natural log of e to the x squared has to equal the natural log of 5. Just take the natural log of both sides. Now we're going to apply the property that says this exponent can be written as a coefficient. So x squared times the natural log of e equals the natural log of 5. Now remember, the natural log of e is just 1, so what we really have here is x squared times 1 equals the natural log of 5. Let me rewrite that. 1 times anything is itself, so we have x squared equals the natural log of 5. Now at this point, we're going to use a technique that we learned earlier. I'm going to extract the root. So here, we'll take the square root of both sides. Now remember, when you take the square root, you need to put a little plus or minus there. Alright, so then we have x equals, as our answer, plus or minus the square root of natural log of 5. Both solutions should be good because look here, when we plug it back into the original, plus or minus will be squared away to plus. Okay, and then e to the natural log of 5 is 5. So they both work. Two solutions. Let me write that in set notation. So the solution set would be negative the square root of natural log of 5 and the positive square root of natural log of 5. Okay, two solutions to this.